Howdy, folks, and welcome to Casa de Scryptar with me, Scryptar. What a surprise. Welcome back to ARK Primitive Plus on the BMP server. So today, first of all, I'm going to show you what I've done between episodes. Last time you saw this, you saw me laying down these thatch foundations everywhere. And then I definitely needed to get a lot of wood to make wood planks and a lot of stone to turn these wood planks and the stone into a lumber construction material. So since then, I got a couple walls up, I got a couple foundations in, and I've placed the first station. So let's go through this. From the outside, there's a sign telling you where you are, so if anybody on the server wants to come and visit me, they know that this is my base. As ownership only says this is our tribe, otherwise you wouldn't really know. So I think that's a good idea. And of course, take your shoes off. This is a freshly constructed building. You don't want to have dirty, right? I finally placed down the cauldron, which we made like a couple episodes ago. It only fit there. I wanted to have it a little more in the corner. But it has to, well, it seems to have a pretty huge collision box, as most of the other things in this game have, like the smithy. You know what I'm talking about if you've ever tried that. So in there, I placed the crafting stations first and then the walls, just to avoid any misconception when it comes to collision boxes. Over here, I had the fences and the wall already placed. And yeah, oh, that's where it is. It's a cooking pot. A bigger one. That's it. So nothing really new to say about it. It looks gorgeous. Definitely. And it's outside because, I don't know, makes sense. Sort of. You don't want to have that stinking in your house when you're making dyes and stuff. You know what goes into dyes, right? I mean, at this time of age, it's usually stale urine and that stuff. You don't want that in your house. Then we have a new apiary. When I was collecting berries around here on a berry. Hi, berry. We got quite a few queens. And I took the three from the raft. So we have a total of 14 queens. This will take a while to spoil. I mean, this one is 3 days. You've seen it on the raft, up to 30 days. So if the next spoil timer after this one is like a month, well, then we have a year worth of queen bees we never need anymore. That's good. I put like 6 drones in here. And look at this. This is already starting to work out quite nicely. So yeah, you want the bees outside, right? You don't want them inside. I mean, we don't have any glass in here, which we might change later to keep the bees out. Then there's a lumber door. As you can see, that doesn't really fit. And I do believe this is the wrong way around. I mean, this wall is definitely facing outside that way. It snaps to the inner foundation. I placed this foundation after I placed that wall. So it has to be this side is the outside. But this door is the wrong way around. You know these horizontal support beams you usually have on the inside, not on the outside. Otherwise, anybody trying to break in could just pry the nails out of this, take them off, and the rest of the door would fall apart. That's why they are usually on the inside. So this door is the wrong way around. That might also explain that weird snapping mechanic here. I hope that's one of the things Primitive Plus is going to fix, because it just looks awful. Seriously. I mean, from here you don't see it, but if you're standing here... Ah. Right. Okay. We have to live with that. Then, let's get over here. Feeding trough. Yes, we do have a new feeding trough. All the stuff we might need is in here. We have a new handmill, in which I have been preparing some spark powder and some berries, some berry juice, some narcotics. And I already made some cementing paste, which I needed for one or two of the crafting stations. We need more of that. Since there's not really beaver dams around to plunder and we don't have a frog, we need to do it the old-fashioned way, chitin stone. So this is going, that's good. Let's keep that going. Our construction table. All the material I currently own is in here, and all the stuff we haven't placed yet is in here. This I took from the boat, large storage box. I do have a new weapon rack, I do have a cooking table, fruit press, and the tanning rack. This is going to go on that side over there, which is the back of the house. As soon as we got, you know, the walls and all of that stuff. We finally have a preserving chair. Very primitive but efficient way of preserving consumables and crops. There's a space too many in there. Over by smoking, over low heat. So 50 slots. I think it's spark powder, I think. What I like about this is that the smoke actually has collision detection. So if you put a roof on top of here, it will like distribute on the ceiling. It's really, really nice. We also have the primitive grill. Interestingly enough, this grill looks way different from the engram point. Engram point? From the engram. Right? This looks more like, I don't know. That's like a big kettle. Like a washing kettle or something like that. Definitely looks different from this relatively modern looking grill, but I don't mind. It's cool. Needs crude oil as a fuel source, although this looks like a coal grill. Alright. Haven't used it yet. And we do have a wooden storage shed. This is one of the specialized storage boxes. Store your wooden items in here, and as you can see, you can put thatch, you can put wood, but you cannot put fiber in here. But you can put wooden planks in here. So that's nice. I will put a window behind this and see that I can, you know, just grab through that window so I can use this lumber station. I think I move that over here, like to the side here. And I can stand just here and unload and load. You know, that makes sense to me. It's a little pity that this has to be on the outside, but I can understand it somehow. Made a little enclosure using the wood fence foundations. These are smaller than the ceiling, as you can see. This is like where the corner is. See, that's why I don't really like patch foundations. You don't see it that good. It's a nice little enclosure for our Lustro. You can reach it. Everything's fine. Yeah, you're happy. That's good. It's aligned with the new campfire right here in the middle. And we have our firewood holder. There's some firewood in here. Fresh firewood. Spoils into dry firewood. I like that mechanic. Spoiling timer for wood. I think we... Do we have or do we want to make?
Scryptar, what are you talking about?
I'm talking about that weird wood thing that actually spoils the wood for us. So bark them out the firewood and convert fresh firewood into dry firewood. Okay, you do that. Well, yeah, it is spoiling. But it was spoiling in the lumber station over there as well, so that's nothing new. I had hoped that this would convert it faster, like you have an engram here to click, like convert, and then would just take... I don't know, this is, what, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, like a minute maybe? That's okay, I think. Give me that. Can I put that in here? Yes, I can. Take that out. And control T that over in there. Something like this. Do I still have stuff in here? Yeah, a little bit. So let's put that in here as well. On the other side of the house, I have prepared the... What's it called? Crafting table? No, that's the smithy. That's the construction table. Right. This is all from drops. Thank you. You in here for the moment. So, drops... battle door frame, scopes, drops are not adjusted to primitive plus here, so you have to make sure that you don't do anything stupid. I don't know if this iron ingot will actually be recognized when... Yeah, it should be, right? It didn't say metal ingot, it said iron ingot. And this is an iron ingot, so I could actually use that to make metal walls. Or door frames, or whatever that was. That's weird. Anyway, coming over here, we have our grindstone. We have our miner's box. It's a wooden box, right? In here. It looks more like a minecart without the wheels. Anyway, it's a miner's box and it can hold... leave it open. Stone, flint, metal, obsidian, metal ingots. It can also hold claystone, I guess limestone as well. So all of that stuff goes in here. 75 slots. That should be fine for a long while. And if we need more storage for stone or something specifically, we can always put up an extra storage box. I put down one forge. I might put another forge over here. If you distribute them a little, you don't get that much heat concentrated in one place, so you're not constantly overheating. Over here, I put down two more foundations. I want to have a gate here. And one gate like here. And that will be the side of the house, so you can use your dinosaurs like Barry, right in here through the gate, and then you can come around this corner and just park in this open area and unload contents into the miner's box or whatever. So you can use your dinosaurs with more weight capacity than you have yourself and get them into the house and out again. Over here, this will also then lead into our enclosed area. I will redo all of this. As you can see, I've stocked up on the second floor here. That was necessary. It works. It definitely works. But it's also not the nicest thing. So I will definitely do a real enclosure which keeps the creature safe. Probably not using these wood fence foundations. They look weird when you stack them up. I would like to have it nice. So we see maybe we use vanilla for that. And then we have basically, like right here would be the corner of the house. So we will have our entranceway going this way. So dinosaurs can get in and out here. And they can also go just inside the house. So there will be a ramp down here or something. And yeah, that's the back wall. That's where we align all the other stations. And of course over there, since there's no door, no entry over here, we can use that space as well. I've been ferrying over all the stuff. Oh, that's what I wanted. Make me some more of these, please. More XP orders. You're still giving boost? Yes, you are. Perfect. And I think I'm gonna go and cook up some meat and put that in there. Otherwise, it's not doing anything currently except for wasting spark powder. Right, today I've checked around. Most of the stuff has regrown. So we have rocks again, and we have those little patches of rocks, you know what I mean. They also give quite an amount of resources. We have a tree over there that's harvestable. We have 1, 2, 3 trees over there that are harvestable. That's all looking good. I get about 500 to 600 wood per tree, and I do want to maximize that. So I think it's time for a mammoth. That would also have the added benefit when we have a wall or a window over here, that we can just ride the mammoth in here, and then I can stand in between and transfer back and forth. So the mammoth won't fit through the regular gates. I don't think it will fit through a lumber gate unless they adjusted something in that mod. Or Primitive Plus DLC, as it's called. I don't know. So we will test all that, but for now, I think I'm gonna unload materials. I'm gonna ferry over some more stuff from the boat, the raft, and when that's done, I get over to that mountain range there and see if I can find us a mammoth that's worth taming. Oh man. This is for sure hostile territory over here. It's freaking cold. At the moment, it's okay, but it was cold just a while ago. There's predators everywhere, and there's like 3 mammoths. There's one at the very beginning of the mountain range. We are actually on the other side, so our biome is there. The one over there was level 12. I think that one here is level 24, and that one there is the one we're going to take, if we can. So I thought... down there looks nice. Let's see if this is still a thing. Hey, come with me. Also, there's Ankies everywhere. I think there's a level 80 among these, which is the highest one I've seen so far. If I find something in that mammoth range, like 100 upward, I'm pretty sure I'm gonna take it. Hey, I told you to come with me. Ow. There's a T-Rex down there somewhere. Not the highest level, but this guy just got attacked by a pack of wolves. That mammoth following. That wasn't the plan. Yeah, keep on going. That still works. T-Rex is over there, so we don't worry about that. And down here should be pretty nice. Yeah, well, scorpions and things. Not much over here. If I can kite it over there, that would be nice. The other one is stuck up there. You. Come with me. kilobytes. Well, that's good. See if we can get some oil. Didn't hit you. Good. Hey, come back. Ew, I'm talking to you. That's rude. Making me waste arrows. Hit. I like this hit indicator. I really do. Hey. You. That's a nice spot to roll over and just play dead. Without actually being dead. Thank you! About time. So, there's turtles and parasaurs, which means there's not much in the way of predators. There's you. Well. I need not that. That, that. Thank you for the arrow, and give me that. Let's see if we can make this happen. Don't know if that's enough berries, don't know if that's enough narcotics. We will see. It's been a while since I played on these settings. It was good I repaired the crossbow, otherwise it would have broken by now. Health was like, or durability was like there. We used up twice that much. Top ore. Yeah, it's okay. Stats, 4,000 health, it's good to start. I mean, it will get some more. Stamina, yeah, don't need that much anyway. Weight needs to go up quite a bit. That's better than anything we have. I can live with that. Now you just need to not die. Since we're here, what are you? An Anky, I know that. 84! That's the best one so far. Do we have enough tranks to do that? I do have some more arrows. I could just quickly... Gimme. Sometimes you just need to think on your feet, or whatever that saying is. No, be quick about it. You know what would be really annoying? Take that sound file, loop it for like a minute or so, and then if you have an alarm clock that can use MP3s, put it in there as your morning alarm. I think that's one of the most annoying things I can think of. Oh. Come here. You. Come over here. I hope there's... No, you're not made boosted in anything, so that's good. You have a very, very nice color. I do like that. Oh, reload faster! That should be a skill. Like, when you can up your melee damage, you should have a ranged weapon skill that just makes you reload weapons that much faster. That would be something. Yeah, no, I'm wasting a little bit of trank here, so should wait 5 seconds. It takes about 3.5 to reload, as far as I remember. Or you could just count that. I'm not really worried about that too much. Yep, you are behind me. That is good. Stay behind me. That'll be even nicer. That was a miss and nobody knows why. No, you're going the wrong way. Not in the water. If you're scared of me, you should run away from me. So, in there. Well, I guess I just wait for you to come back. Are you coming back? Anytime soon? Hello? That's rude. I had that already. You're so close to the edge of where it goes deep. Yeah, now you're in there. That's awesome. All kinds of stuff in here. Well, not really. You can drown in there. Hmm. Alright. I will keep an eye on that guy, and on that guy, and I'll meet you right back when that's done. Number one, 25 barracks, no narcotics. That was reasonably fast, like 25 minutes. The mammoth is over there, so I had to chase this guy all the way over here, and then it finally broke down. I managed to salvage some trilobites. This is unreal. There's trilobites everywhere. That's actually the master himself, Mr. Boden Maddox. Had a quick look around the base. That looks quite nice. It's a lumber building. I don't see a smithy. I don't see a crafting table. Or construction table. I don't even see lumber production anywhere, but obviously it seems to work for him, so that's good. I might do a server tour a little later on when we're more settled in and our main building is done, so that you can have a look at all the different stuff that's going on. Now I just need to try and get back over there without dying, and there's mentors around here everywhere. And there we go. Little too late on the keys today. Gorgeous. So, Mr. Boden Maddox, I stole some of your berries. I hope you don't mind. I bring them back, I promise. So, we have almost 3,000 health, 600 stamina. That's not too bad. I can leave it at that. We do need to up the weight quite a bit since we're gonna go metal hunting with this guy. Melee 215 is also not bad. Standard movement. Yeah, that's okay. What about you? Hey, let me touch your cloaca here. 5,500 health, almost. That's perfect. 1,000 stamina, that's also perfect. Way too much in the way of food. 750 weight is a real good start. 216 melee, 222.6 movement speed. Awesome. Since you were the reason we came here, here's a saddle for you. Nice. Now, we just need to go and find our way back home. Bye! The heck? Warp trilobites. This is awesome! That's exactly what I need. So I brought home some oil from the trilobites, and I fired up the grill, killed a couple creatures along the way, you know, trikes and dodos and carnos and everything that's roaming the beach area. So what I did is basically we were over here, that was where we tamed the mammoth, and over here is where we tamed the Anky. And there's a passage through here, and then I went all the way around the outside edge of the beach, all the way over here, up the same slope we took the last dino train, and then came over here. That is the best way to go. We could have gone straight through here. From here is no way to get over to that peninsula other than going around. At least not with a mammoth, because it won't fit through that lock. I don't believe so. I haven't tried it yet. I might. Since we're already here, I might actually do that. For the Anky, that shouldn't have been a problem, but all of this is T-Rex and Allosaurus and Sabertooth and Argy territory. Didn't want to risk it. Not without having saddles for everybody. So, around the outside edge is twice as long, but it worked, definitely. We're here. There. Anky is there. I put up some more structures. Storage boxes and weapons rack, which can be used for tools. You can't put arrows or ammo in here, which is weird. But okay, I can live with that. Once this has finished cooking up, it's really hot here now. I will store all that away in here. You belong to the very top, so I can see you. And you belong to me. Yeah, we'll fill up the feeding trough, make some more narcotics, so probably... Yeah, it looks good. Store all the stuff away, and prepare more lumber. This has already worked. I harvested one tree, the one that's... You know, usually right in front of the gate there. That's what I got. 1, 2, 3, 4, 500, and a little bit. Harvested the same tree yesterday with the metal hatchet. 380 or something like that. And of course we can get berries. It's nice. It looks good. It's decent speed. Let's take this one over here. Should have enough weight. This morning that one gave 290 with a hatchet. Now I have way too many stuff. Anyway, I guess that's it for today, folks. If you like the video, subscribe for more, leave a comment if you feel like it. Don't forget to enjoy yourselves. Yay, see you soon.